I said at the beginning of my conversation with you, is that we have people all over the state of Tennessee that say, I'm on the exchange, I can afford the premiums because I'm getting help with that, but I can't afford the deductibles, and so therefore I can't even begin to use my insurance. So, you know, you got to take it more than just talking about the isolated CSRs. It's more than that. And as long as you keep those mandates there and people can't get what they want for a cost that they can afford, I think that you're going to continue to have this problem. I'd like to see the president just write an executive order to say no longer are there individual and individual mandates and employer mandates. You know, if you just did that and you got that out of the way, we could actually start to let the market work. The market works everywhere else. When I go to the grocery store, the market works. The market works in other places. But and I think we need to let the market work.
How does the where has the market worked on health care when you have... I guess, not to get into a philosophical discussion, but when you have every doctor saying that if anybody that comes to an emergency room, they're going to treat them, you're not, it's not a market, right? You're being forced into figuring out how to subsidize that free health care that nobody pays for in the emergency rooms.
So let me tell you, Chuck, I'm an emergency room nurse. There are people that came into my emergency room that I, the nurse, was the first one to see them,
right,
that I could have sent them to a walk-in clinic or their doctor the next day, but because of a law that Congress put into place to say, no, I have to treat everybody that walks in that emergency room, you took away our ability to be able to say, no, an emergency room is not the proper place. And then you put a burden on top of that to say, you must do that.
So you would get rid of the law that mandates emergency rooms to see every patient that shows up.
I would get rid of a law that says that you are not allowed as a healthcare professional to make that decision about whether someone can be appropriately treated the next day or at a walk-in clinic or at their doctor.
Right.
But we must treat everybody that walks in, whether you've had a sore throat for a week. We must see them. And that crowds the emergency room. It drives the cost of emergencies up. And so, yeah, if someone comes in from an auto accident, I don't want to ask whether they have insurance or not. I'm going to take care of them. But what it did is crowd my emergency room where I work and disallowed me from using my good judgment skills, of which I was trained to do and doctors are as well. And it's the federal government said, you must and you can't make those decisions. And I think that was a poor thing for us to do. It's driven the cost of health care up, and especially in the emergency rooms.